Right, Huffington Post contributor Kimberly Johnson taken to task online for this now deleted tweet. It says, out on the road the other day, I saw an affluent black man driving a BMW with two bumper stickers. One was pro-NRA and the other one was a Tea Party sticker that read, don't tread on me. This left me very confused.
NRA TV host Colleen Noir has a response to her, and he joins us now from the great city of Dallas. Colleen, good morning to you.
Good morning. Thanks for having me, guys.
When you saw that tweet, it bothered you. Why?
Well, it bothered me because it kind of prejudged me or kind of characterized me as being someone who can't believe a certain thing simply due to my race. And so when I initially saw it, I felt offended. But then immediately after that, I thought, you know what? This is actually an opportunity. There's a lot of this discourse that's been going back and forth, especially on Twitter. And I saw it as an opportunity to have a conversation, which is why I invited her on my show so that we can actually converse back and forth about, okay, why do I believe what I believe? And then why does she feel the way she felt about why I believed it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is one example of so, so many that we see today on social media. It's a great place to attack someone without knowing one thing about who that person is and why they think the way that they think. So she then deleted that tweet and she responded to what people were saying about it. She said, I deleted it because people were putting words in my mouth and changing my original intent. For the record, I do not believe everyone should vote the way I do. However, I am free to wonder what motivates people to vote. And what did you make of her response to that? Because it seemed like her original tweet, she was very clear about what she was trying to say there.
Oh, no, she was absolutely clear. It was pretty evident that she made an assumption about a black man in a BMW based on the bumper mm-hmm. stickers he had on his car. Me, personally, I'm anti-bumper sticker. However, as a black man, but I am also a black man who has built a platform based on a right that not so long ago was denied to people who look just like me. So I think it only makes sense that an organization like the NRA, who protects those rights for everyone, that whether you're black, white, green, you're gonna support that. And so it shouldn't be any question to her. But nonetheless, she had the question and she's wondering, and I'm more than welcome to have that conversation. And I think we're at a precipice where I think the conversations are starting to happen. I was just on Bill Maher where I was able to have that conversation and we were able to meet on the middle ground in some respects. Yeah. And I think that's the first step. And so hopefully we can continue that on with her coming on my show or anyone else who wants to have that conversation.
Colleen, you said, I even feel bad as she is somewhat a victim of her own identity politics. What did you mean by that?
Yeah. Well, I don't know her. I don't know what her actual beliefs are, but going based on her comments, it makes it seem like she was around a certain group of people and felt that she understood what black people are supposed to think. And I don't know how broad her experience is, but it seemed very, very small considering what she posted on Twitter. And so I think what's happened throughout the last several years is there has been this identity politics where if you fit a certain group, you sit in this box and this is exactly what you're supposed to think. If you step outside of that, we're going to shame you so that you either go back, or if you don't go back, we're going to ostracize you socially.
Yeah, and Colleen, this is not just about her, right? I think this speaks to what we're seeing play out across this country, people being kicked out of restaurants because they prejudge them based on who they work for or a hat they're wearing. What is the message you have this morning to people, regardless of their race, regardless of their political affiliation, of how we move forward more together with respect?
If the ultimate goal of this country is for us to all live together in this country in peace, we have to have conversations. We can't just shun people who don't agree with us off to another place and not want to interact or deal with them. We've got to have those conversations. I think we're past the point now where we just start slinging insults back and forth and sit down and talk to each other. Because I think once we start doing that, we'll start to realize we have more in common than we realize. Mm-hmm. And at that point, we can start moving the needle forward and actually start finding solutions to the problems that we do have in this country.
Yeah, maybe you both have a dislike for bumper stickers. You just don't even know.
Well, thanks for carrying
on. I don't like bumper stickers on my car.
There you go. Well, thanks for carrying on the conversation here with us today.
Absolutely.
From NRATV, Colleen Lyon. Noir, that is to say. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me, guys.